I'm Scott.
And I'm Puck.
Puck is my magic wife.
I don't know if I like that term.
I'm the kind of guy who will throw anything in and try it. Whereas Puck's the kind of guy who has to know exactly what steps we're following.
But we both come from the same school of thought when it comes to magic, so we create very well together.
Puck's the serious guy. I'm the funny guy. But every once in a while, Puck has a zinger that comes out.
Actually, the funniest lines in the show come from me.
Really? Like which ones?
Exactly. When we first started putting it was different, and we started just working at our strengths. We're from different neighborhoods, completely different backgrounds, but yet when we put it together, it actually worked.
Please welcome Scott, Alexander, and Pat.
Scott, Alexander, and Pat. These two guys advanced all the way on America's Got Talent.
Scott Alexander. It's the magic of Puck.
And have teamed up to deliver an evening of magic, mischief, and mayhem.
Well, you don't see it? How about from this side?
America has voted.
Magicians and comedians who were finalists on America's Got Talent here today, Scott Alexander and Puck, talking about your performance at the Downstairs Cabaret this weekend. Welcome.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
And so you guys were on America's Got Talent. Talk about the duo here. A unique one.
Yes. There have been very few comedy magic duos or illusion duos, and none that are a black man and a white man doing an act together. So we were like, we can use magic to speak and talk about diversity, racial issues, social issues, and we can also make it entertaining and fun with the magic.
Yeah, how did people respond to that?
I think that was very well accepted.
Yeah.
And it's been doing very well, so you know, we're excited about it as well.
Thank you so much. Well, folks, the piece we'd like to do for right now is actually illegal in 48 states. Not that one.
The other one?
The other one.
My bad. This one?
That's the one, yes.
Oh, okay. Oh, I see we got a couple college graduates out there. Wow. Fantastic. Well, back where I come from, on the East Coast, it's actually illegal to own one of these things. In fact, they'll throw you right in jail. And but when you think about it, 300 years ago, if Puck and I were to stand on a public stage and do magic tricks for people, we could be arrested as witches or warlocks, right? Which is weird, because even the good book itself says that both of these things are fine and should be done together. It says right there, he who practiceth necromancy and sorcery must be stoned. Now, Puck and I don't actually smoke this stuff anymore. We found a magical way around it.
Yep, and we don't use any paraphernalia either. Check it out. If I roll my fingers like this and ball my fist, I can fall in the bowl of a pipe. If I extend my thumb, I can actually create the stem. The only thing we need now is a little bit of imagination.
What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song, and I'll try not to sing out of key.
Too hard.
examining those knives, you may have noticed evidence of epoxy and glue and tape. That's because we made those knives ourselves. And we made them to look exactly like this. Phony stage knife. See, you can do all kinds of stuff with this. Like this. Ooh! Always a crowd pleaser, that one. Alright, folks. See if you can keep your eye on the phony knife. Folks, the name of this game is Grab and Stab. In just a moment, Puck is going to thrust his hand into the bag of knives, which is dangerous enough in and of itself. He's going to grab one knife, and one knife only, and heave it into my chest. Now, he'll be moving with such speed that should he fail to grab the phony knife, there'll be nothing he can do to stop himself. That's right, folks. With Scott and Puck, you may have paid for your whole seat, but you only need the edge. Joe, please.
Houdini. You guys like Houdini?
I like Houdini.
You know, as magicians, Houdini is kind of a big hero of ours. You know, it's, in fact, if you could go back in time and, like, talk to Houdini, what would you say to him?
I don't know, Mr. Houdini. I'm a big fan of your work. You're one of my heroes, one of my magical inspirations.
Yeah. What do you think Houdini might say to you?
1920s? Yeah. He'd probably go, get my bag.
Times have changed. Well, Houdini was famous for three things, other than mild racism, evidently. He's famous for getting out of a straitjacket, escaping from handcuffs, and...
He's also famous for the fact that he did with some sewing needles. Now, when Houdini did this, he used 5 sewing needles. We're going to duplicate that, but instead we'll be using 10 2-inch solid steel embroidery needles. Scott's going to bring them out there in the audience, and as he does, come by, just go ahead and grab one, check it out.
Grab a needle. Perfect. Take a needle, any needle. Good. Examine them. Make sure each one is a genuine sewing needle. Purchased from the Joanne Fabric store. Unfortunately, Joanne Fabric doesn't give us any money for saying that, but there you go. Take a little now. All right. Perfect.
Well, to me, this is a white cotton thread, about 3 feet to be exact. And 3 feet is about, see about that's right there. Now watch.
Anybody else's life turn out not quite the way they anticipated? Speed it up. This ain't 1920.
Oh. That was the easy part. The hard part's out there with you. Those needles, we need to get those back. You good? Yep, top it in the glass. Perfect.
Hey, welcome to the palace.
I hope you guys checked him out really well.
Get those dollar bills out.
Now, when Houdini would take those needles, place them on the tongue, he would swallow them. They would go across the tongue, down the larynx, through the fallopian tube. It's science, technical stuff. It's, you know.
Next thing we need to do is to lubricate the needles.
And that's done with this tube of KY jelly.
Now that's for on the way out.
All right. Water on the way in.
Yeah, water in, KY out.
All there right, here we go. Cheers.
Thanks, Al. There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, I should stab him again. Ladies and gentlemen, right now, we'd like to present you our version of Houdini's Needles. Needles right up top.
about magic, you just like the scales of music, there are scales of magic, but the thing is to elaborate on those and to make them your own, and that's when you become an artist, when you start to deconstruct the original methods, make your own methods, and your own presentations, and that, you know, that's art.